So now here with Christina Schieber at the end of this special edition of Autos Here to 60 about Porsche, because first I usually do one segment for a car, but this is such a special car and so many things going on with Porsche that it deserves probably more than one show. That's what I can do now.
Well, it's exciting times at Porsche for sure.
Yeah.
And being able to introduce the 918 Spyder to individuals such as yourself is very exciting for us. And we make sure that we do it in a fashion where it's exemplifying a consumer experience. So what is somebody who's buying a 918 Spyder going to experience in going through that purchase process?
Yeah.
So we're here today at the Formula One racetrack in the United States, Circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas, and we've closed down the track for the day. And this is gives you the rare opportunity to get behind the wheel, one alone, and drive all those fantastic modes in the car and feel the amazing performance. Two, to be with professional race car drivers that truly know how to rip you around that track. And three, it's all about the hand-holding. It's the one-on-one experience that we're trying to deliver.
And that car, I mean, for people fortunate enough to be able to buy that car, I mean, it's an important purchase. We're talking about close to $1 million. But more than that, it's like a lot of technology. So, like, as you were saying, like, all the experts from the factory and, like, from Porsche North America come here and explain everything to everybody who is doing the program, right?
Every touch point is important for us to explain and exemplify to the ultimate end user, which is, today it's you as a journalist understanding. But at the end of the day, it's our customer who really wants to know from the chief engineer, from a race car driver, because he's listening and looking for different things, from individuals like myself to understand, you know, what are you getting behind just owning a Porsche? Because it's not just owning a Porsche. You're stepping into a whole new lifestyle. And that really treads what we're doing across the country, is getting into more regional markets, speaking with more people on a one-to-one level, and helping them to truly understand beyond the performance, technology, and purest passion that people usually have for Porsche, and understand what the lifestyle is behind it. What does it mean for me to own a Porsche? Yeah. What are the other benefits that I get from being part of the Porsche family?
Yeah, and those kind of things are changing, because car manufacturers have been making cars for like a long time already. But this kind of interacting with other parts of the company itself, of other activities, and you like, this facility is great. But also last week we were in Miami, or in Bal Harbour, the Sand Ridges, a fabulous property. Also at the Sony Ericsson with Maria Sharapova, the Porsche global ambassador. So there's a lot of things that come together when you're like saying like experiencing the Porsche.
It's the experiential side of things. Yeah. So why do we go to the Saint Regis? Well, because it actually exemplifies a little bit more of who we are as a brand, and we put that whole experience together so you can come and spend time and understand who we are, what we're doing, and enjoy yourself. The cars are amazing, but the life behind the cars is just as amazing.
And they take you to a beautiful place.
Take you to beautiful places, exactly. But again, you know, what we try to do is deliver the customer experience to you as a journalist so that you can exemplify that and help people to understand what it truly is to experience Porsche.
Okay, talking about Porsche experience, you're opening a couple of new facilities here in North America, which are going to be
state-of-the-art.
Exactly. And that's going to be like the place where like people are going to be able to experience in that place everything about Porsche, right?
Well, Porsche definitely wants to be a leader and be the most aspirational brand in the world. And in order to do that, one, we align ourselves with people like Maria Sharapova as the global brand ambassadors who truly get the car and the design and the life behind it. But we're also opening Porsche experience centers on both coasts. So on the East Coast, we're opening up what we call One Porsche Drive, which is our new North American headquarters, which will also have a test track facility. So here's where individuals can come and, again, have the touch point access with individuals who are the engineers, the marketers, the PR people behind the cars, and they can ask whatever they want and then feel the car in a performance track facility as well. So they can do their 0 to 60s, but at the same time, they can learn how to fine-tune their skill in driving a Porsche. And in Los Angeles, of course, we're opening a Porsche Experience Center there as well, which will be the house of not only our test facility, but our motorsports will be headquartered there. We have a human performance center. So if you want to talk about your athletic ability what you can do to enhance in yourself physically to become a better driver, we can do that for you as well.
You should take Donovan McNabb and ask if drivers are real athletes and see how it goes.
I tell you, you know,
he's really one of your first guests.
He's one of our first guests, exactly. And Or he should be one of our first guests, I'm saying. But like even Patrick Long and Timo, you know, they'll be with us at these experience centers as we kick them off. But again, it's an opportunity for consumers to have one other touch point and access to Porsche and really just maximize their full customer ownership experience.
And you already have the Porsche Driving Academy in Birmingham, right? Correct. So what's going to happen to that?
That's going to stay there, absolutely. That serves a whole nother purpose in terms of these are test facilities in the sense that we're not talking about high-speed tracks. Like, we're here at an F1 track today.
This is different.
Very different. We want customers to understand capabilities of the car and how to fully use them, but it's not a high-speed. It's not about going the high-speed.
Yeah, you're
not going
to win a trophy there.
Right. Although, if you're driving, we'd put the straight right alongside the 405.
Oh, that's...
So, as you see cars that are, you know, on the side of the road, even if you're going 120 miles an hour, which is an extreme speed, you're going to feel like you're going 160.
You're
going
to make a lot of people envious.
Yeah, probably.
For two reasons. One, the Porsche, and two, the speed.
Exactly. So, you know, that school is a very strong point for us, and it will continue to do exactly what it's doing.
Yeah. And that facility, what's the schedule for those?
Well, the end of this year, 2014, is when we're opening one Porsche Drive in Atlanta. And then the Porsche Experience Center in Los Angeles will open in the first quarter of 2015. So we're getting close.
And besides experiencing the tracks and all those kind of things, are these going to be like delivery points where people can buy a car and then just take it there? Like in Europe, they do more. Like the Volkswagen Group in Wolfsburg, they have this, the AutoStadt, which Porsche now is part of it, which is fantastic. So it's just more or less bringing that kind of thing.
Absolutely.
Also?
Dealers will be able to do deliveries of cars at the performance centers, the experience centers, so they can, you know, truly enjoy the full-on experience of, here's my car, what do I do, how do I do it best, kind of a thing. So yes, that's going to be a strong point. And then there's going to be gourmet restaurants. And so after a long day on the track, you can sit down and have a fabulous gourmet culinary experience as well.
Like a Disneyland of cars, huh?
Oh my goodness. It really is going to be so beautiful. And there's going to be, even in Los Angeles, like a spectator hill.
Yeah.
Because that's part of the joy of listening to cars. I mean, we're here today watching 918s rip around the track, 911 Turbo S's, and we're driving our Panamera SE hybrids. But to see it, too, is part of living it.
Absolutely. Well, Christina, thank you very much again for your time, both last week in Miami and this week here in Circuit of the Americas in Austin. It's been a real pleasure, and I mean, a lot of things. I see a lot of things coming for Porsche with the Macan. That's another story. Maybe another one-hour show.
Absolutely. Well, it's a pleasure to have you. You look at every little angle of every aspect of the cars and the programs, and you get it. So we appreciate you being with us.
Thank you very much, Christina.
Fantastic.
Y con esta entrevista a Christina Shiver, la responsable de lifestyle, de estilo de vida de Porsche North America, estamos llegando al final de este show muy especial para la cobertura del Porsche 918 Spyder que se realizó para Norteamérica aquí en el circuito de las Américas en Austin. Realmente un auto fabuloso, cuesta $845,000 para comenzar y obviamente es un auto solamente para coleccionistas. De hecho, Porsche solamente fabricará 918 unidades, de las cuales prácticamente ya todas están vendidas y las pocas que quedan seguramente no durarán mucho. Un auto fabuloso. Y quiero agradecer a Nick Tewark, a Christina Shiver también del equipo de Relaciones Públicas de Porsche North America, también a Patrick Long y a Timo Klock, los pilotos de la escudería Porsche, también a Peter Valdez Depena de CNNMoney.com, a Edgar Ferrara del Circuito de las Américas, quien nos recibió ahí la semana pasada y también tuvimos una entrevista con él sobre todo lo que está sucediendo en una de las mejores pistas de automovilismo en todo el mundo. Así que bueno, el Porsche 918 Spyder desde el Circuito de las Américas. Esto ha sido una edición especial. Los espero muy pronto. Ya se acerca el Auto Show de Nueva York y seguiremos viajando y trayéndoles todas las novedades que suceden en el mundo de los autos. Yo soy Javier Mota. Les recuerdo una vez más, me pueden seguir en Twitter, @JavierMota. Y sobre todo, vayan al canal de YouTube, Autos Javier Mota, para que disfruten de todos los videos que realizamos ahí en el Circuito de las Américas con el Porsche 918 Spyder. Esto es Auto 060 aquí en Christina Radio Network.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.